Hello students, welcome to class 4 of your module 5. So in this class, we are going to discuss about the last topic of this module 5, that is about polyhedra, then quadratic surfaces, in that spline representations, its types, convex hulls, then the very important concept, that is Bezier spline curves. Okay, so these are the important topics that we are going to discuss in this session. Based upon this topic, we have our lab program, that is an animation of a flag. Okay, so that complete program is relied on this particular topic. So you have to focus more on this topic, and from the exam point of view also it is very important. So let us understand one by one. So first of all, we will start with the polyhedra. Okay, so polyhedron, in the plural we call it as a polyhedra or polyhedrons. Okay, is a kind of solid figures that are having many plane surfaces. Usually they consist of more than six faces, okay, or plane surfaces. So it is a kind of object in which it consists of many plane surfaces. Okay, by usually we will consider that it should have more than six. The most commonly used boundary representation for three-dimensional objects. So this type of polyhedron based objects mainly used for boundary representations whenever we are dealing with the three-dimensional objects. A set of surfaces, surface polygons that enclose an object interior. So with the help of these surfaces on our object will make our object very solid in nature. Which this polyhedron simplifies and speeds up for rendering and display of objects. All the surfaces are described by use of linear equations. So the linear equation is nothing but, for example, if you are using the line, it will become y equals to mx plus c. Okay, we know that the linear equations whose equation is having the degree 1, often referred to as a standard graphics objects. Okay, that is nothing but I hope in your teapot program you use this glut solid cube. Okay, so in this glut solid cube we are just specifying the width of the cube. Okay, width, or sometimes we also call it as a length. Okay, that does not make any differences. Okay, so by using that values we are going to determine the size of that particular cube. And in many cases, graphical packages allows us to define the objects as curved surfaces, such as spline surfaces. Means normally the graphical packages will not give us only the standard graphics objects. Sometimes they also will give us a kind of curved surfaces, okay, curved objects. The such examples in us is nothing but spline surfaces. Okay, in that we have a type of quadratic surfaces, cubic surfaces, then linear surfaces. These are the various types of objects that we can see whenever we are using the spline surfaces. We will discuss what is a spline surface. First of all, we will study what is a spline curves. Then we are going to focus on this spline surfaces. The next, this polyhedron is used to define the polyhedra. Okay, we simply define the vertices of the polygons required. Okay, that is we have used a glut wire sphere. Okay, as I've said that in the teapot program, that is a glut solid teapot or glut wire teapot. Okay, in that place, if you want, you can place this sphere also, which is nothing but glut wire sphere. You can go for glut solid sphere. Okay, which always takes the three parameters, that is a radius for that sphere, then the stacks and slices for that sphere. So these are the typical examples for this polyhedron. Okay, so here all these polyhedrons are having wired shape. Okay, means a kind of tessellations can be seen on this particular surfaces of the object. Okay, the next one is a quadratic surfaces. Okay, quadratic surfaces are, before going for this quadratic surfaces, we should know about the quadratic curves. Okay, the quadratic curves are nothing but these are the curves which are having the degree. Okay, the degree of this one is 2. Okay, for example, x square plus y square equals to r square. Okay, where this equation is having the degree, the highest degree is 2. So such kind of curves, okay, that we are going to draw with the help of this 2 degree, okay, polynomial equations. Okay, that type of curves we call as a quadratic curves. And with the help of that curves, whenever we are drawing the surfaces, such type of surfaces we call as a quadratic surfaces. A frequently used class of objects are quadratic surfaces. These are three-dimensional surfaces described by using the quadratic equation, that is having the second degree equations. So example for this one is a sphere. Yes, you can remember your sphere equation, that is x square plus y square equals to r square, okay, or x minus xc whole square plus y minus yc whole square equals to r square, okay. The next one, I hope you can remember your ellipsoid, torus, paraboloid and hyperbola. That's nothing but y square equals to 4ax, okay, or sometimes x square equals to 4ay, okay, some kind of equations I hope you can recall. Okay, similarly the hyperbola, that is nothing but x square by a square plus y square by b square, okay. So such kind of equations in which the degree of that equation will be 2, okay, the maximum degree will be 2. Such kind of equations we call as a quadratic equations. With the help of that equation, whenever we draw the curve, we call it as a quadratic curves. And with the help of that curve, whenever we draw the surfaces, we call it as a quadratic surfaces. If you want, you can go through this particular link. Okay, if you want to know about the additional equations, okay, the equations for this quadratic objects. So here, these are the examples. Okay, this is the ellipse, then elliptic paraboloid, hyperbolic, okay, some two sheets cone, okay. So these are the different type of shapes that we can observe in this quadratic surfaces. Now, in the quadratic surfaces, whenever we take an example that is a sphere, we know that a spherical surface with a radius r, okay, centered on the origin is defined as the set of points, okay, that is x comma y comma z that satisfy the equation. Means whenever we take a sphere, okay, or a simple circle, okay, so the center, okay, so that is nothing but the centroid of the circle or the sphere, okay, so which is having the equal distance between the each and every vertices of that that perimeter of that particular circle or sphere, okay, so that distance we call as a radius, okay, so that equation should satisfy this x square plus y square plus z square equals to r square, okay, because we are going for the sphere, so we should include the z. If you are dealing with only on the circle, it will become x square plus y square equals to r square. Okay, this can also be done in a parametrical form using the latitude and longitudinal angles. That is thing, but if the geometrical equation, okay, if you want to represent in a kind of parametrical form, okay, parametrical form here, this pi and theta are nothing but they are the parameters, okay, whose values is in between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 and minus pi to plus pi respectively. Okay, this type of equations we call it as a parametrical form of equations, because this pi and theta, these parameters will give the values for x, y, and z, because these are dependent variables and these are independent variables. You should not go in detail about these things, but you should have some idea. The next one, ellipse, okay, I hope you can recall this x square or x by r, x whole square plus y by r, y whole square plus z, okay, because it is a three dimensional, so z also we have included, e is equals to 1. Okay, this is our normal geometrical equation. Whenever we write it in a parametrical form, we will get such kind of equations. Again, the parameters are phi and theta. Similarly, we can go for the torus or a donut kind of shaped object, okay, whose equation is root x square plus y square minus r axial, okay, whole square plus z square equals to r square, okay, it's a parametric form will be this one, okay. Whenever you see this sphere, ellipse, torus, you can see that here the highest degree is 2 only, okay. So such kind of objects are nothing but quadratic objects. Now let us understand what is this spline. Okay, what is this spline curve? Spline curve is a smooth curve that is defined mathematically using the set of constraints. Means this spline curve is a kind of a curve that is controlled by the control points. Okay, here set of constraints are nothing but control points. Means here this curve that you can see here, it is controlled by some set of control points. Okay, so whenever we change the control points, okay, this particular curve is also going to get changed. Okay, we will going to see that one with the help of animation. Okay, for now, just remember that the spline curves are nothing but these are the smooth curves, okay, that are controlled by set of control points. Okay, they are controlled by set of control points. Spline curves, its applications will be normally in the two-dimensional illustrations, whenever you're dealing with the fonts, okay, and their styles, and three-dimensional modeling, and especially whenever you're using the animations. Okay, at that time, this spline curve plays a very important role. Okay, so what is the big idea of this spline curve? Here, the user can specify the control points. Okay, so how many control points that user can you want, he can specify that one. So because of this control point, we can define the smooth curves. Okay, so now here you can see that there are four control points are there. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, when the four control points are there, which indicates that our curve is having the equation whose highest degree will be 3. Okay, so whenever the equation, okay, degree is 3, the control points will become 4. Okay, in general, if I say that if any equation is having the degree n, okay, then the number of control points that can be used is n plus 1. Okay, so this is the major concept that we should remember. Okay, so for n plus 1 control points that can be used for the n degree polynomial. So in this spline curve, we have two types. One is interpolation and the one is approximation. Okay, so as we have seen that spline curve is specified with the use of set of control points. Means a spline curve is a curve which is controlled by the set of control points. Okay, there are two ways. Okay, one is interpolation and second one is approximation. What is this interpolation? Here, the curve passes through all the control points. You can see that this is the curve in which this curve is passing through all this red dot, which are nothing but control points. It is passing through, okay? It is passing through that control points. Such kind of spline curves we call as an interpolation spline curves, okay? This is the first type of spline curve. What about the next type? That is approximation spline curve. Here, the curve does not pass through all of the control points. Means here, the first control point and the last control points has been connected with that. That curve is connected to the first point and the last point, but in between the control points, it is not going to connect it. Means you can see that from here it is started and it is not going to touch to that control point. It is having some distance. Similarly, it is going to keep some distance over here. Similarly here, and finally it is going to get connected with this control point. Means in this approximation spline curve, the curve does not pass through all of the control points, okay? All of the control points, but it can be connected with the first control point and with the last control point, because the first control point and the last control point, they will act like the holder, okay? Like a kind of holder, means whenever you use a rubber band, okay, whenever you keep it between the two fingers, okay, so the first finger is controlling, holding, and another finger is also holding. So, okay, in the same sense, okay, these two control points are holded that curve, okay. Okay, so then the spline curves, we have two types, interpolation and approximation spline curves. The next one is a convex hulls, okay. This is the boundary formed by the set of control points for the spline curve, okay, that we call it as a convex hull. Okay, so you can see here, there are totally four control points are there. P0, here P1, P2, and P3, okay. So with this particular four control points is going to create its own boundaries. You can see with the dotted lines, okay, this is the boundary. And within this boundary only, our curve should move. Okay, our curve should move. Okay, if that curve goes out of the boundary, okay, that curve, that we don't call it as a convex hulls. Okay, it became a concave hulls. Okay, because it is coming out of the boundary. So similarly, you can see here P0, P1, P2 and P3. Okay, within its range only it should move. Okay, means our curve should not come out from the control points. It should be within the control points limit. Okay, so here this example, the examples that we have used here is, it is the approximation spline curve, because this curve is not at all passing through all the control points. Okay, so P2 and P1 is kept at some distance between the curve. Similarly, the P2, P1, okay, they are having some distance. So it is a approximation spline curve. Here, the control graphs. Control graphs is nothing but a polyline connecting the control points in the order is known as control graph. Control graph, in the simple sense, is nothing but it is a graph, okay, created by the control points. Okay, it is created by the control points. Such kind of graph we call it as a control graph. Means whenever we change the place of this control points, based upon that the curve's behavior also get changed. So hence such kind of graphs we call it as a control graph, usually displayed to help the designer to keep track of their splines. Okay, we will see each and everything with an example, okay, so that you can understand. Now the next one is a Bezier spline curves. Okay, it is the advanced version of a spline curve. Okay, so here a spline approximation method developed by the French engineer Pierre Bezier for use in the design of Renault car bodies. Okay, Bezier is nothing but the name of a scientist who has used this approximation spline curve. Okay, so this approximation spline curve is the method, okay, that is developed by this Bezier. Okay, hence they are given the name Bezier spline curve or simply spline approximation curves. Okay, so he was an engineer in the Renault car. Okay, he was a mechanical engineer. Okay, he has introduced this particular idea, which is, this curve is a very useful in nature, convenient to use and easy to implement on the paper. The Bezier curve can be fitted to any number of the control points, although usually 4 are used. Okay, so this Bezier curve, which is nothing but the spline approximation curve. Okay, we understood that what is approximation curve. It is a curve in which all the control points are not at all passing through the curve. Okay, the curve is not at all passing through any of the control points. Okay, so in the Bezier spline curve, that curve can be fitted for any number of control points. Means you can use n number of control points, but usually the 4 control points are sufficient to draw any complex kind of objects. Okay, so that is the thing. But if I'm using the 4 control points, means what will be the degree of my polynomial? That will be 3. Okay, so the degree of the Bezier polynomial is determined by the number of control points to be approximated and their relative position. Means with the help of this degree of a Bezier polynomial, okay, for example, if I take the highest degree of the polynomial is 3, okay, so I can go for that 4 control points. Means if I take n is the degree, then n plus 1 will be the control points. Okay, so this is the degree. Okay, this is the polynomial equation, okay, in a pictorial form, is having the degree 3, okay, and that is controlled by the 4 control points. Now consider the case that is n plus 1 control points, okay, that can be denoted as a pk equals to xk, yk and zk, where k varies from 0 to n, okay, that is 0 to n. N plus 1 control points means, assume that my equation is 3. Okay, let me take 2. Okay, 2. So 2 plus 1 means I have using 3 control points. 3 control points are there. So here 0 to N. 0 to N means how much? That is 0, 1, 2. Okay, so totally 3. Okay, as I am using the 3 control points. The next one. The coordinate positions are blended to produce the position vector, that is nothing but the P of U, which describes the path of the Bezier polynomial function between the P0 and Pn. Okay, P0 is the first control point and Pn is the last control point. Okay, these two control points is going to hold the curves. Okay, and In between these two, whatever the control points are there, that is going to control the curvature. Okay, so here the position vector, that's nothing but a p of u. Okay, where u is nothing but our parameter whose values ranges between 0 to 1, means the minimum value is 0 and maximum value is 1. Okay, we will see that how it will be useful. The next one, this is a p of u, that is a positional vector, is equals to the summation of, which starts from k is equals to 0 to n, which in this pk. Okay, pk is nothing but what? Xk, yk, and zk. You can apply the k value for it. Then Bezier, okay, k comma n of u. Okay, so here, what is this Bezier, k comma n of u? Okay, so this is, we call it as a Bernstein polynomial, okay, or simply we also call it as a Bezier blending function. Okay, we call it as a Bezier blending function, or sometimes we call it as a Bernstein polynomial. So that is nothing but this Bezier k comma n of u is equals to, this is a combinatorics of n comma k, okay, into u power k into 1 minus u to the power n minus k, where we know that the combinatorics, okay, so its value is n factorial by k factorial into n minus k factorial. Okay, so here assume that this is our equation, the Bezier spline equation. So here this equation is nothing but this equation. So in place of a pk, in place of this Bezier of u, we have introduced this particular equation. Okay, we have introduced this equation. Now assume that I want to use k is equals to 5, means here k is nothing but the degree. Okay, now the degree of my equation will be 5. Okay, so how many control points that I'm going to get? Okay, I'm going to get a 6 control points, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so I got a total 6 control points, which are those 6 control points: p0 p1 p2 p3 p4 and p5. And you can see here highest degree will be u of 5. Okay, means u to the power 5. Okay, so when I have the 5 degree, okay, how many control points I will get? I will get 6 control points. Okay, because n means a degree plus 1 is gives me the control points. Okay, so here, whenever we process on the individual, for example, in place of the p of u, okay, that is for the x, y, z combinedly, if I go for individual for x, individual for y, for z, okay, that particular equation, okay, this particular equation will be, will come as, this particular equation become, that is, x of u, okay, in which xk, then that is xk, okay, then similarly for the y, it will become with the yk, and for the z, it will become zk. Okay, so these are the different Bezier spline curves. You can see that this is having the 3 control points, so the degree of this particular equation will be, or this graph will be 2. Okay, so here it is having the 4 control points, so it is a quadratic equation. Okay, it is a cubic equation, right? Here the degree will be 3. Okay, and here there are 4 control points, it is a cubic equation. Okay, similarly it is also cubic equation, and here it is having 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, so 5 control points are there, means the degree will be 4. Now, some of the important parameter properties for the Bezier curves will be, the first and last control points are the first and last point of the curve. Okay, that is p of 0, that is a p naught, and p of 1. Okay, here 0 and 1 is nothing but u. Okay, so minimum value is 0 and maximum value is 1. Okay, so which indicates that if I am taken the one control point, that is a p naught, and one more p1, okay, it will start from the p naught and it is going to move towards the p1, okay, sorry, pn. Okay, so here the u value will be 0, and when it's moving towards it, it will become p of 1. Okay, that is what the representation here. The curve lies within the convex hull, has the Bezier blending function, or all are positive and sum is always equals to 1. Okay, because the minimum is 0 and maximum value is 1 for that parameter. So 0 plus 1 is 1 always. Okay, so our blending function, that is with respect to x, with respect to y, and with respect to z. Okay, its sum is always positive and it is always equals to 1. So if you go for the cubic equation, okay, cubic equation, okay, you can get, okay, cubic equation means the degree will be 3. Okay, so here you can see that 0 of 3, 1 of 3, 2 of 3, 3 of 3. That is nothing but a k of n, k of n, k of n, k of n. Okay, we are keep on incrementing the k values. Okay, so there is a summation will be there. This is a plus, then plus, then plus, and then plus. Okay, you can see that here the highest degree will be 3. And how many control points we got? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, you can name here P0, P1, P2, and P3. Okay, so totally we will get a 4 control points. So here the Bezier linear curves. Okay, linear curves are the curves in which whose degree, okay, is equals to 1. Okay, for example, if you take this particular line, okay, if you take this one as a y equals to mx plus c, okay, what is the degree here? That is 1 only. Okay, so in that, it is the starting point and it is the final point. Okay, in between that, here we have taken the parameter as t. Okay, you can go for t or u, whatever is sufficient for you. Okay, so it will start from 0 and it will to move towards the 1. So in between that, it will get the point, it will get going to get the values like a 0.25, 65, 68, 70, okay, like that. Okay, once it reaches to 1, it will become 1. Okay, so I will go with the animation, don't worry about that one. Similarly, the Bezier quadratic curves are nothing but whose degrees are 2. Okay, so whenever the degrees are 2, the control points will become 3. Okay, so it will always move from this place to this place. Okay, from this control point to this control point and this control point to this control point. Okay, with the help of that, a curve can be drawn. Okay, similarly, the higher order means here more than three control points are there, means the degree will be 3. Okay, so these 4 control points are sufficient for our Bezier curve to draw any kind of complex curves or surfaces. Okay, this is the fourth order. Fourth order means degree will be 4. The number of control points will become 5. Then the Bezier curves. The Bezier curves is nothing but, Bezier surfaces. The Bezier surfaces is formed with the Cartesian product of blending functions of 2 orthogonal Bezier curves. Means if you are drawing the Bezier curves, okay, first you are drawing with respect to x-axis, okay, once the x-axis drawing is happened, then you can go further drawing with respect to y-axis. So you are going to get a kind of surface. It is nothing but our kind of our cloth material. In the cloth material, you can see that a kind of horizontal threads and vertical threads will be there, right? Okay, in the same sense, we are going to use here. This P of U is used for drawing with respect to x-axis. Curves will be drawn with respect to x-axis. B is nothing but the curves will be drawn with respect to y-axis. Okay, so for this U, we are going to use m plus 1 control points. And for the V, we are going to use n plus 1 control points. Okay, so it depends. Okay, for example, here the degree. Okay, if the degree is a 3, okay, for the complete surface. Okay, so here also 4 control points and here also 4 control points will be used. Okay, you can see here. Okay, so this is the one with respect to, this is the x-axis. Okay, then with respect to y-axis. Okay, so kind of wireframe Bezier surface is constructed with the 9 control points arranged in the 3x3 mesh. This is our 3x3 mesh. So totally 9 control points has been used. Okay. So similarly, whenever we are using this 4x4 kind mesh kind of thing, okay, then we are going for 16 control points. Okay. So this is the explanation. Let us switch to the simulation part. Hope you can understand by looking at the concept. See here, this is the animated Bezier curves. Okay, so this particular equation, it is nothing but it is a linear equation. Okay, that is nothing but you can take it as a y equals to mx plus c. okay, it is starting from P naught and it is going to move towards the P1. So in between that, the T naught, T value, T is nothing but our parameter value. You can see it is keep on changing. It is started from zero. Once it reaches to one, okay, again, it will going to reach over there. Okay. But here animation purpose, it is coming back again. And this is our quadratic equation, means the degree is two. So the control points will be three. Okay. So whenever it is moving from this place to this place, okay, C, okay, this place, and from this P1 to P2, it is moving, okay, and here from this point, from this parameter value to this parameter value, the particular graph will be, or the kind of curve will be drawn. Similarly, here we can see that it consists of four control points. The four control points means it is a cubical equation, cubic equation. Okay, so here it is a kind of somewhat a complex. Okay, means it is going to move from here to here, and it is moving here to here, and it is moving here to here. Okay, so they are connected with each other. It's a kind of connecting rods. Okay, in the mechanical, we have seen this crank connecting rods or crankshafts. Okay, that kind of connections will be there. Okay, and it is going to draw the curve like this. Okay, so this is having the totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 five control points are there, means the degree of the equation will be 4. Okay, so this is the differences that we can observe. Okay, let us understand with one more example. Okay, let me take one control point. Okay, let me take one control point over here. Okay, there is a one more control point over here. Okay, so what is the degree of this particular line? That is nothing but 1, right? That is y equals to mx plus c. Okay, so if the degree is 1, means how many control points will be used? That is, two control points will be used. Okay, if I play here, you can see that it is moving, that is the u or the t value starts from 0 and it is moving towards the 1. Okay, so a simple drawing can be done over here. Okay, is a kind of line can be drawn. Now assume that I have used one more control point. Okay, so now what is the equation here? Now three control points has been used, means the degree of our equation will become 2, means x square, okay, or y square. Totally the degree, highest degree will be 2. Okay, whenever I play, okay, you can see that it is moving from this side to this side. Okay, so its t value is going to get changed. Similarly, from here to here, its t value is going to get changed. In between these, okay, from this t1 to t2, okay, again the value, this is going to get changed. So because of that, this particular big circle, okay, or big dot, it is going to plot the curve. Okay, this is for the degree 2. If I go for degree 3, okay, degree 3 means how many control points? 4 control points can be used. If I draw, okay, so this kind of complex can be drawn. If I go for one more control points, okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is the degree? What is the degree here? That is 4. Okay, you can see a kind of complex curve can be drawn over here. And similarly, if I go for one more control point, okay, now you can see that, observe this big circle, okay, how it is going to draw, okay, it is going to draw, okay, very complex curves and all. Okay, if I go with the one simple example, let us take one simple example. Okay, let me take my name only. Okay, that is a start with yes. So this is the one control point, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So 16 control points are there. So what is the degree of my polynomial? It will become 15. If I play here, you can see the kind of the curve it is going to draw. Okay, which is very complex in nature. Okay, so any kind of equations can be, any kind of graphs can be plotted. Okay, but the Bezier curve is sufficient with the four control points. Okay, we are not going more than that. Okay, because unnecessary control points are going to put the burden on our system. Okay, so this is the Bezier curve. Okay, in the next class, in the next session, I'm going to talk about your lab program, that is a flag animation. So here I'm going to stop. Here it completes your fifth module. Thanks for listening.